Good morning, everybody. It is May 14th, my sister's birthday today. So happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Debbie. Happy birthday to you. And oh, so many more. I love my sister. And she's been checking these videos out since day one. And I am so appreciative of that. And another one of our favorite Clubhouse members, Toby, said this is her birthday today, too. So happy birthday, Toby. I've got my one-on-ones beginning in a little while. It's a full day of visiting Clubhouse members who signed up for our one-on-ones. So I'm going to go ahead and jump in and put a little music to start the day with. One of my favorite people I always got to work with was the great Kris Kristofferson. I did solo work with him, and I did all the stuff with he and Rita Coolidge together. And he's a trip, boy. He is just one fabulous character, you know, smart, and you know, when we get in the studio, we had nothing but fun. He really enjoyed being in there and enjoying the process. So I'm going to go back to an album that we did back in 1975 called Who's to Bless and Who's to Blame. It was produced by David Anderle, who I did lots of work with. I love David. And when he finally retired from producing, pretty much everything, most of the work he did was came off of the A&M lot. He went on to do his other great passion in life, which was painting. And he was a really great painter, did beautiful, beautiful work. And we lost him a number of years ago, but his legacy is deep. So David Anderle. It was engineered by John Haney and Kent Nebergall and Wayne Daly. Did a lot of work with those guys, but John Haney especially, lots and lots of albums with John. And the band on this is really just great. It's myself on bass, Sammy Creason on drums, Mike Utley on keyboards, Fred Tackett and Jerry McGee on guitar, Nick DeCaro on accordion, and Bobby Hall on percussion, and the great background singers, Rita Coolidge, Clydie King, Terry Paul, Herb Peterson, Billy Swan, Vanetta Fields, and Mentor Williams. Mentor Williams is Paul Williams' brother. He was an artist, also did his stuff, and he wrote Drift Away for Dobie Gray. So it's a great group of people. My gut's telling me we probably did this over at Sunset Sound. I didn't see a credit on that, but so much of the stuff that we did with Kris and Rita, we did there. So I'm guessing. It's just guesswork, but it's a great studio. But I'm sure wherever we were having a good time. And then Kris is singing and playing 6-string and 12-string guitar on it. So I'm going to go ahead and play some music, and then I'm going to get set up here and get started on my one-on-ones. So here we go. Here's a song called Silver, and then in parentheses it says The Hunger. So here we go. A happy Saturday, everybody.
Wicked reputation. Music was his magic, and his madness rode in one. They said he charmed the fairest hearts, this world's fairest maidens. Slick as silver mercury and slippery as the sun. Winding like a river through the thirsty world of strangers, carving out a legend in a dream-forsaken land. Silver took his pleasures just as freely as he gave them. Hungry eyes weren't quick enough for Silver's flashing hand. Then once upon escaping from the world of silk and shadow, sudden growing sicker of the secrets and the shame, he stumbled stumbled onto something real. The beckon like a candle. Never looking backward, he surrendered to the flame. Because hunger is a surface of a dark and cool old sadness. Soft defenses, soon unfolding mysteries he'd never seen before. Awakening an ancient need, she slipped inside his senses. Silver took it easy as the closing of a door. Secret fear she'd hidden with her sorrow, darker than a raven hand, deeper than her eyes. Dared to try to lead her through the sunlight from the shadow, following the line between her laughter and her life. But silver left his magic with a legend he'd abandoned. Love had stripped him naked of illusion and its charms. One long night a changing mind took kindly to a stranger. Morning found him moving in the golden stranger's arms. Because hunger is a surface of a dark pool of sadness. Soon be a reflection of a deeper. Time was burning, frozen in the oceans of his eyes. Sadly turning backward to the world that he'd forsaken, he donned the shining mantle of deception and disguise. Slowly, with the patience born of silent desperation, silver worked his way into the darkness of her mind, weaving through her conscience like a chance she might have taken, sadder than shadows of the love she'll never find. And silver's spell was stronger than the softly smiling stranger. Two stars was burning smaller in the naked light of day. Silver took her hand again, a wiser man but sadder. ready for the stranger who will steal her love away. Because hunger is the servant of a dark pool of sand. So here's a wretch, a head deeper need be drawn. In magic of the
see too many artists nowadays doing 8.5 minute songs, big storytellers. Let's jump into a little up tempo here. This is called Cuss the Fiddle. So here we go. This is Kris Kristofferson from Who's to Bless and Who's to Blame.
I scandalized my brother while admitting that he sang some pretty songs. I'd heard that he'd been scandalizing me, and Lord, I knew that that was wrong, and it was. Now I'm looking at it up, something cool and feeling fool enough to see. But I had called my brother wrong, now he had ever right to call on me. Don't ever cuss that fiddle, boy, unless you run that fiddle out of tune. That picker there in trouble, boy, ain't nothing but another sign of you. If we ever get to heaven, boys, it ain't because we ain't done nothing wrong. So let's settle down and steal each other's songs. I found a wounded brother drinking bitterly away the afternoon. And soon enough he turned on me like he'd done ever face an absolute. Well, we cussed him to the ground and said he couldn't even steal a decent song. But soon as it was spoken, we were sad enough to wish that we were wrong. Don't ever cuss that fiddle, boy, unless you want that fiddle out of tune. That pecker there in trouble, boy, ain't nothing but another side of you. And if we ever get to heaven, boys, it ain't because we ain't done nothing wrong. We're in this gig together, so let's settle down and steal each other's song. know that it sounds silly, but I think it I just owe somebody the fun.
If you're not familiar with Kris, it's well worth looking him up on Wikipedia. He's had a fascinating life, from Rhodes Scholar to all kinds of stuff. He's an amazing, amazing guy, you know, who achieved some good success as an actor, but just a truly kind of like a Renaissance guy. He just did a little of everything. So it's a good read. So go check him out. Here's a song, the last song I'm going to do here, because I got to get ready to get started here. This is called The Year 2000 Minus 25.
Welcome to the year 2000 minus 25. Oh, say, can you smell her for the smoke? So he's gotta be alive. Who says he can't take a dirty joke? Power isn't, power does, power slips away. It's so easy to abuse. Who'd have thought that mayor would have bought the USA just to give it to the Jews?
Had long fades that went on forever in the studio. It's always kind of fun. You just, it's all this good stuff. Sometimes they would cut up stuff that would really got into it towards the end and put it up there. Otherwise, you just lost the stuff to history, and we knew it was there. So I got to get running here. I'm just about ready to start my one-on-ones. Again, I'm going to wish my sister a very happy birthday and Toby also. And wish everybody just a great, great weekend. It was just got up or cracked really because it's only not 8 a.m. yet. Just watching some stuff still going on in Ukraine, watching reports of COVID numbers going up. It's a world we got to be aware of every day. There's so much going on, and there was a whole thing going on about books that are still trying to be banned. You know, it's like, wow. And they're great books. They're wonderful books, and it's just shocking. I mean, the conservatism that's reared its head about wanting to get rid of, you know, things about the Holocaust and things, because it's upsetting. No shit, it was upsetting. Millions died for it. We shouldn't be ignoring it and trying to hide it from future generations. I'm going to get going here and thank everybody who works frontline, hospitals, you know, any place where you're dealing with public. These people are really putting themselves in harm's way every day. And I appreciate their service so much for what they're doing and have done over the past couple of years. And fingers are crossed for the Ukrainians. There's so many. The list gets longer every day. But I just want to wish everybody all the best. And I'm going to start visiting folks now. So I will see you tomorrow. Okay, bye-bye.